Yeah, you, sorority girl. Just in case you accidentally wander into a voting booth one day, there's some things you should know. And one of them is, there is absolutely no evidence to support the statement that we're the greatest country in the world. We're 7th in literacy, 27th in math, 22nd in science, 49th in life expectancy, 178th in infant mortality, 3rd in median household income, number 4 in labor force, and number 4 in exports.
What's wrong with the world, mama? People living like they ain't got no mamas. I think the whole world's addicted to the drama, only attracted to things that'll bring the trauma. Overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living in the USA, the big CIA, the Bloods and the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate, and to discriminate only generates hate, and when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate, and that's exactly how anger works.
I'm Kate Rosenblum from Mouse, and to me, media literacy is about getting real people represented in the media that surrounds us every day.
Can you practice what you preach, and would you turn the other cheek?
I learned early on to look for that untold story. One time, we were at my Nana's house. She had a TV, and a commercial came on, and it was one of those ads where a man gives a woman this large diamond ring, and she smiles, tears up, and the music swells, indicating that they are going to live happily ever after. My dad turned to me, rolled his eyes, and said, well, I guess I don't love your mom because I never gave her a diamond. It was comments like that that taught me media could be decoded.
So I could ask myself, really, what is going wrong in this world that we living in? People keep on giving in, making wrong decisions, only visions.
Keira Knightley is given a bigger bust. Jessica Alba is made smaller. Kelly Clarkson. Well, this is an interesting. It says slim down your way, but she in fact slimmed down the Photoshop way.
I want some love, y'all.
People killing, people dying, children hurt, pain, even crying. Practice what you preach, and what you turn the other cheek. Father, 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 help us. Need some guidance from above. Cause people got me questioning. Where is the love?
Where is the love?
This test shows that Old Spice is the right choice. Old Spice performs in real man situations like basketball, recon, and Frenching.
My mom would always point out every time the cheerleaders would come on, okay, so look, here's the story that gets told. The men get to be this heroic, skilled athletes, and the women just get to be pretty. And she didn't mean any offense to any, you know, individual young woman who was working as a cheerleader, but just the concept of that, she wanted my brother and I to be aware of it, because we see these images on TV and in movies and in magazines all the time, and if we don't stop and think about it, it just sort of seeps into your brain, and that becomes the way you perceive reality.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Nagel, and I work at the Jacob Burns Media Arts Lab. And to me, media literacy is understanding the world around us, engaging, and responding.
Where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love? Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning.
I think more students should study media literacy because in today's age, we can't avoid the media. It has become intertwined in our lifestyles. There's no way to exist fundamentally and participate without having a grasp of how the media is. Media and citizenship, media and civic democracy are often tied at the hip now as we increasingly have less physical community space and more mediated community space. And I think media literacy is the bridge to that understanding and bettering society as a whole.
It's not even summer. Why is the DJ keep on playing Summertime Sadness?
After doing the bathroom?
Well, hi folks, Michael DeJuani from Brisbane, Australia here. I think media literacy research is so important because there's so much we don't yet know about how young people can most effectively learn about the media.
Let me take a selfie.
You know, with media, divorce is not an option. You're going to be using media and interacting with media for the rest of your life. So we need the skills to learn how to do that.
Can you guys help me pick a filter? I don't know if I should go with XX Pro or Valencia. I want to look tan. What should my caption be? I want it to be clever.
Another reason why media literacy is important, besides thinking of it as an expanded conceptualization of literacy, is to think of it in relation to mitigating some of the challenges, or even, shall we say, the risks associated with living in a media and digitally saturated society.
Selfie. Selfie. Let me take a selfie.
Are you Stephanie?
How do you know me?
How you doing? I'm Jack.
Did you just make that up and you said that?
No, Elena, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. I was just going to say happy birthday. Someone in your family is referred to as Pops. Is it like a dad or a grandpa or something?
You were tripping me out right now.
Really?
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Hi,
happy birthday to you too, because I know you were actually, I should have said it to you because yours was before hers. But
media literacy research is important because all literacy research is important. It's political. It's about voice. It's about power. It's about value. It's about possession. It's about dispossession. But also curation. It's about how people curate the textual bric-a-brac of their lives in the digital age.
The world in only three categories: number of incarcerated citizens per capita, number of adults who believe angels are real, and defense spending, where we spend more than the next 26 countries combined, 25 of whom are allies. Now, none of this is the fault of a 20-year-old college student, but you nonetheless are, without a doubt, a member of the worst period generation period ever. Period.
When you don't go your way. Now I see all these big shots whining on my evening news about how they're losing billions, and it's up to me and you to come running to.
My name is Jad Melke. I teach media studies at the American University of Beirut. I think media literacy is about empowering individuals and communities and whole countries.
What's interesting about the media is, yes, they're just a tool for doing things, but they're not neutral. They are owned by big companies. They are very often owned by companies headquartered in a country other than our own. They are run for profit. So a lot of the interest in media and digital literacy in the conference was about helping young people understand what happens to their data, who owns their images, how certain profit motive generates what comes up in a search engine, not the desire for knowledge.
In the real world, they're shutting Detroit down. Here in the real world, they're shutting Detroit down.
Now we're at a point where some kids grow up immersed in social network sites, in YouTube, and Flickr, and Twitter, who have acquired the skills at navigating through the digital space. And those kids have a habit of mind, a way of processing information that is going to serve them well in schooling, to serve them well in the workplace of the future.
Now, we'd all pay lip service to the idea that there should be a dynamic relation between theory and practice. But actually, how does that relationship work out pedagogically? We could say we're looking for critical practice. But what is critical practice? How would we recognize critical practice when we saw it?
Detroit down, while the boss man takes his bonus pay and jets on out of town.
When you ask what makes us the greatest country in the world, I don't know what you're talking about. Yosemite? Sure used to be. We stood up for what was right. We fought for moral reasons. We passed laws, struck down laws for moral reasons. We waged wars on poverty, not poor people. We sacrificed, we cared about our neighbors, we put our money where our mouths were, and we never beat our chest. We built great big things, made ungodly technological advances, explored the universe, cured diseases, and we cultivated the world's greatest artists and the world's greatest economy. We reached for the stars, acted like men. We aspired to intelligence. We didn't belittle it. It didn't make us feel inferior. We didn't identify ourselves by who we voted for in the last election, and we didn't scare so easy. We were able to be all these things and do all these things because we were informed.